This is so cool. I use all this stuff. It's really cool. So I've had a lot of my musical dreams come true in my career, but perhaps one of the most exciting was the first time I recorded at Skywalker Ranch. And I'm sure you won't be surprised that when I walked in the door for my very first session, I did exactly what many of you would have done. I asked to immediately hold a lightsaber, which they actually obliged. Subsequently, I got to hold Indiana Jones's bullwhip. So they didn't need to pay me after that, but I still did cash the check. Okay, maybe I did. Okay, so now with a very special presentation, please welcome from Skywalker Ranch, Mr. Dennis the Wiz Leonard.
Dennis Leonard tribute speech, Dennis Q's video. Okay, I'm Analog. BT, great show so far, you know, I really like it. I put everything on these cards, and in homage to John Cage, I should shuffle them and just randomize it. I was lucky enough to actually work with him. But what I was really lucky enough to have done over 35 years ago was meet John Meyer. And I've learned so much from John and watched John create Meyer Sound, which was something that he kind of backed into with the Grateful Dead pushing him a little bit because we wanted to push the envelope, and John had the wherewithal to push the envelope, and we had a good time. Some 30 years ago, I was running the Grateful Dead's fabrication shop, and we did outside things, and we got a contract with McCune Audio, which was one of the first places John designed things. And I saw these boxes we were building, Jam 3s, and they were actually something I'd never seen before, which was a comprehensive approach to building a system. We, in the past, would engineer a system and decide on the crossovers, the equalizers, the amplifiers, but the sound guys still had the latitude to, you know, let's try this crossover today, let's try this frequency today. And sometimes it was good and sometimes it wasn't. But what it did do is it took up a lot of time just getting the box to work before you even EQ'd it for the room. And here were these JM3s, it was like a box, and there were wires that went into the cabinet from this electronic box, and it was all done. It was a comprehensive approach. And I thought, you know, that's pretty cool. And fast forward, I think it was the 79, we had this film, Apocalypse Now, that was circulating. And John had built these subwoofers, really great subwoofers, because at the time, movie theaters didn't have enough low frequency. And Francis and Walter and the people from Apocalypse wanted the room to shake. And everybody knows how legendary that film was. Well, after the film, there were these great speakers left. And the Dead had closed Winterland the New Year's of 78. And we started to think about what we're going to do. And we went over to Oakland Auditorium, which is now Henry Kaiser, closed, unfortunately. And everybody in the Bay Area that had ever done anything in live sound got together in September to put together this crazy, arcane system. It was impractical as hell. We had vacuum tube amps. We spent 2 days putting the system in. You know, unheard of. You know, like now you go in and you do build and show. And John showed up, everybody showed up. Don Pearson, God bless him, was there. We time aligned the system, and we had this experience that was unbelievable, and this group formed that all loved sound, and John was kind of at the center of it. Fast forward a little bit further, and one evening, and I was lucky enough to build the first Ultra Monitor, the first product of Meyer Sound, the prototype box, and we got called down to the Warfield Theater, and there was this box on the stage. It was kind of crude, but totally functional. And I don't know who got to hear it first, but I walked up to the box and stood there, and John was off stage right, and he spoke to me. And he knew the visceral reaction I was gonna have, because I looked over and there was this Cheshire Cat grin on his face, because he knew, you know, I'd never heard anything like that before. It sounded so real. I looked down at the box and it's John, but it's bigger. It would have to be a John head this big to be that loud. It was natural. It was something that we had never heard before. The Starship were the first band to use them. And in fact, they had gotten so used to working with old school that we had to add DDLs and other things into the monitor mix in order for them to continue to feel like they were, that previously they'd been harmonizing with the distortion in the system, and now there was no distortion at all. And you know what I'm getting at is, I think for John it's all about passion. I think John approaches everything with unbridled passion. I remember having a conversation with him over at Meyer Sound about eliminating bottled water and getting filters for the water. And you know, here's a guy, yeah, he's a sound guy, but John immediately knew everything about filtering water, absolutely everything. And that's the way he is. You know, it's not just about sound. There are so many ancillary things that float around in his head. It's a little scary, but you know, he is incredible. And one of the things that I've learned, and it was also handed down from Bear, Owsley Stanley, the famous guy that was the benefactor and beginning of system, yes, I am experienced. Never be satisfied with status quo. And I've seen it happen, you know, okay, yeah, it's done, but gee, we could have done this. Well, guess what? The we could have done this is the next part of the project, and it keeps going on and on and on. This constant quest to make it better. If you can, you absolutely have to. And, you know, thank you, because that is the greatest gift you've given me. And there are just so many products out there now, and one of the things that I'm really fortunate to have been a part of is the development of cinema products, which has happened in the last few years. That's the world BT mentioned. You know, I live at Skywalker Sound. I listen to Meyer Sound products absolutely every day in my room. Thank you. And now we're in the cinema world. So John Meyer, please come up here. Thank you so much for everything you've done.